Welcome, everybody. My name is Ivet Galabova, and I'm here today to tell you about HiGHS. HiGHS is a set of solvers that we have been working on for the past couple of years now. And we're almost ready for our first official release. So it's a short talk today. So I'll jump in with some more details about HiGHS and then about its performance, and then a little bit about the team at the end. HiGHS supports linear programming problems, mixed integer programming problems, and quadratic programming problems at the moment. It's been developed in the University of Edinburgh. Julian Hall is my supervisor and the person who started HiGHS originally. I've been around for a while. It was first based around the parallel dual simplex solver, and later we added further problem types. For LP, Julian is a simplex guy, so we have simplex. There's the interior point solver as well. The interior point solver isn't being actively developed at the moment because the person who wrote it left Edinburgh already. We have been using HiGHS for various academic and industrial applications. The HiGHS source code is freely available on GitHub. HiGHS is licensed under the MIT license as well, so you can check out the code anytime you like. I'll get to the core part of this talk today, which is the performance of HiGHS around about the time of our first official release. So the goal here is that that we become the best open source solver around, and the levels of the MIP solver and the LP solver are already very competitive. All three solvers have recent updates and are being actively maintained. Here, this first set of benchmarks is for LP. We're comparing HiGHS against CLP on Mittelmann's current test set of LPs. There's a score number that you see, and it's Mittelmann's shifted geometric mean normalized so that the best solver has a score of one. So in the simplex case, you see that CLP's score is one, meaning that CLP has solved more problems or faster than HiGHS. There are a few remarks I would like to make about these benchmarks. First is that the HiGHS timeout was said to be lower than CLP. Julian did the benchmarks recently. So the timeout limit was set to 3,600 seconds rather than 115,000 seconds. And the lower number of problems solved by HiGHS is due to that. So there's another point I would like to make about CLP. CLP uses some tricks that are not present in HiGHS, and also it has a primal simplex solver that it switches to sometimes. So there is scope for improvement in HiGHS in that sense. Further below, you see the results for interior point solve, and the HiGHS IPX solver already scores better than CLP. And I need to mention that the results on Mittelmann's website are outdated as well. It's a far previous version of HiGHS, and we aim to get those updated as soon as the release is out. Here you see performance for MIPS benchmarked very recently as well. The only funny thing about the timing is that the timing of HiGHS is done on Leona Gottwald's machine. Leona is the person who wrote the MIP solver, and the times for CBC and skip are from Hans Mittelmann's machine. Again, the score that you see is the Mittelmann's shifted geometric mean normalized so that the best solver has a score of one. Skip is first with a score of one. and HiGHS has 1.7, which is already less than CBC. Leona is the person responsible for the MIP solver and its great performance. She joined us from Germany last year and has done a spectacular work over the past months. We have been working on integration of HiGHS within other languages and programs. There is a HiGHS.jl package on the Jump Dev repository, and it's some of the functionality is already present. There is a little bit of scope for improvement still in some of the special functions. Apart from Julia, we use C++ for HiGHS and a CMake to build on different platforms as well. We have a C API, which is called which can be called by Python. And also there is a version in SciPy already implemented. Julian has been developing a skip integration as well for anyone interested. And we have various other bits of interfaces in different terms of progress. So if you have any questions about anything particular, please don't hesitate to reach out. Okay, and at the end of the talk, I'll tell you a little bit about the team. So Julian Hall is a lecturer in Edinburgh University. I've been working on large sparse linear programming problems for the past few years, and HiGHS has been a great project to be involved with. It's taken a lot of time, but I'm very excited for what we have come to oversee and to support, and I'm very, very happy to be a part of this project. So Michael Feldmeier joined us from Germany. He's another one of Julian Hall's students, and Leona Gottwald is our MIP person who has been working with HiGHS since last year. Yeah. And this is a little bit of further information, a link to the GitHub repository. We have a website as well. There was a guide on the website, which should no longer be there. We have official documentation for the release. And there are some references for any further information. Again, please don't hesitate to reach out. Thank you very much for your time and attention. It's been a pleasure. Bye.